Where am I? What? Fully dressed. This isn't the bathroom. What the hell's going on here? Hello and welcome to another episode of Mondo Squalido. Have not said that in such a long time. Yes, it's been quite a while since the last episode. I have no idea what happened, but evidently I'm back home where it all began all those years ago. So as you can see, I'm ready to go. I'm pretty prime and looking fantastic as I usually do. And apologies if I'm a little bit rusty, because it has been quite a long time, but thanks to the wonders of editing, a great staff around me, great support, it's going to be seamless. But what exactly are we going to be watching today? Yes, folks, we are going to be looking at the 1977 Roberta Findlay classic, A Woman's Torment. So without any further ado, let's get this show on the road. Do we have any red wine here? No? Okay then, I can wing through it. Frances and Don are a couple whose relationship is on the rocks. When Frances isn't sleeping with her best friend's husband, she's also got to deal with her Asian stepsister Karen, recently moving in with them. You see, Karen is a girl with some issues. To put it very, very, very lightly. One night after overhearing the troubled couple discuss their options, Karen decides to stay at the family's house on the beach. A fresh start with even fresher sea air should do the trick, right? Yeah, as soon as she arrives, she not only begins to shut herself off from the outside world, but also starts to hear things and hallucinate. Whilst reacquainting herself with the family beach house, try saying that 10 times with a lisp, she's visited by Larry the electric guy, who is as concerned about her well-being as he is odd. Although initially afraid, Karen is overcome by horniness and seduces Larry. Well, his fingers at least. After Larry shows us just how well electricians can truly use their hands, he believes Karen should return the favour, which goes well. Seemingly untroubled by her sister's unsupervised outing, it's business as usual for old high society Frances and her daytime cocktails and entertainment. Oh well, later that evening and after a shower, Karen gets a visit by a modern day liberal. A nosy, overbearing, eco-warrior wench. After inviting herself in and giving Karen a lecture, she gets a nasty surprise. Karen starts the next day by doing her interpretation of a Bjork music video on the beach. And a little bit later on, she's visited once again by an unannounced party. This time, a love-struck couple looking for fun before the prison sentence of marriage, which goes as to be expected. After a couple of days of no contact, Frances is getting nervous and sends Otis, her best friend's husband, who happens to be a psychologist, to check up on her. And of course, will Otis be another victim of our mentally disjointed nymphette? Or is he, or a certain part of his anatomy at least, the key to her recovery? A Woman's Torment is a nice little shocker that has echoes of Polanski's Repulsion, albeit with that seediness you'd come to expect from a Findlay production. Although not the most disturbing offering, it certainly packs a punch, mixing great psychological horror with even amounts of sex and violence. The violence isn't comically over the top, and the sex is far from titillating, but it's definitely effective and helps make the film stand out. That's not to say that there isn't a tiny bit of campiness that sometimes creeps in and takes that bleak and harsh edge off the film. Although Tara Chung puts in a great performance as the damaged Karen, she does tend to take it to the point of absurdity,
but that just adds an almost surrealistic tone to the film. The standout performance for me personally was Michael Gaunt, whose character is all kinds of subtle creepy. Is that a new term, Peter? Really? Walter Sears' moody score combined with imaginative editing techniques and use of sound all add to the atmosphere, mood, and all-round uniqueness of the film. Far from perfect, but still a memorable experience.
It was only a matter of time before Vinegar Syndrome got the greasy, crusty, smutty hands on this grindhouse classic. And boy, have they done an absolutely wonderful job on this. Not only do you get two absolutely wonderful pieces of artwork, including the iconic poster, but you also get the R-rated version of the film, which is a completely different experience in itself. To complement that, there is a commentary track for the R-rated film with Roberta Finlay herself. Not only that, it keeps getting better, folks. There is an interview / Q&A with Roberta Finlay, as well as an interview with Michael Gaunt, who, as I said, puts in an absolutely wonderful performance. So yeah, it's about time a classic got this treatment, and I can't think of any other company to do it justice than Vinegar Syndrome, another shining star in their back catalogue. It's great to see this smutty classic released in the way that it should be. I can't think of any other company than Vinegar Syndrome to do this release justice. And it's great now that old fans and potential new fans alike can experience what is one of the more infamous entries into the world of classic adult cinema. It's safe to say that once again, this is a highly, highly recommended release for all you sleaze hands out there. Well, that wasn't too painful, was it, ladies and gentlemen? Don't all answer at once. I hope you enjoyed this review. Apologies once again for being such a long time since I've done a proper review on the channel. Hopefully within the new year, yes, I'm dating my videos again, we can get the Mondo Squalido train on full steam, get some really nice classics reviewed and looked at for you guys. And as always, if you've watched this film or any other films by the absolutely wonderful Roberta Finlay, then your feedback is always welcomed in the comments. Give me suggestions for episodes in the future. Check out those playlists for previous episodes. And hopefully next time, it won't take me as long to get another fucking episode out. Here's to hoping. See you guys later, and yeah, you guys stay safe. You know, it's been a long time when you can't remember how you end videos.